Hi guys, well, I've got about 10-15 minutes to spare, ish. Want to wait for Mum to turn up. She couldn't come up this morning. So, a bit later than planned. It's now coming up to 4:05. I've been doing a bit more tidying. I've dusted all the Lego shelves, cleared the desk. I've just got a few things to put away, such as these, some rubbish to clear up, that's about it really, and a bit of vacuuming. I did get a delivery this afternoon of 6 mountain bikes. Two ladies, 4 men's. One dual suspension bike and the rest are all rigid, and the other 3 are rigid frames. Out of the 4, I've already got a lady's bike in full working order. All I had to do was nick a front wheel out of one of the gents' bikes. I'm going to scrap because it's not worth doing. It's so badly rusted and the frame is all bad, it just isn't worth the time or effort. So that's a parts donor bike. So I nicked the front wheel out of that to put in this lady's bike. Pumped the tires up. I went for a ride. I had to make a tiny adjustment to the rear gears on the cable adjuster. That was it. That's all I've done. All I've got to do now is go down and give it a clean and photograph it, and that's already ready to go. The second lady's bike, after I pulled the grass out of the wheels, the frame is in top condition. It's a rally. The other one's a cheap budget bike. It's a Emil. I don't know how you pronounce the bloody name. But the other one I've got is a rally. One of the rear brake thingies was stiff, so the rear brake wasn't actually moving at all. I've left it to soak in some WD-40 after taking the securing bolt out. Front brake worked fine, gears are working fine. Again, once I sort that rear brake out and get that working properly, just a clean down and that's good to go. There's an Apollo gents bike. Well, it's the frame only. There's no wheels and no seat, but everything else is present. And from what I can see, if I just chuck in a couple of wheels, I've got some tubes I can take out of the other two bikes I'm going to scrap. There's an orange Apollo. I'm going to scrap that. And this other black thing, that'll be scrapped for parts, because those two aren't worth doing. But this Apollo one is. It's sort of like a greeny, turquoisey blue colour. Frame is in good nick. Bottom bracket needs an adjustment. It's not seriously loose, but there is a little bit of play, so I'll just adjust the cut on that. Put 2 wheels in, and tyres, and tubes, and whatnot, and then just make sure the gears and the brakes work, and that'll be that one good to go. And then there's a Muddy Fox dual suspension bike, silver and red. Not too bad, does need a good clean. Does need tubes in the wheels. I'm not sure it's going to need a new set of, if I've still got them up here, new set of these fitted, because it's got odd pairs on there. It's actually got a red pair on the front. I've never seen a red pair before. So I'll put a matching pair or a matching set on. And as long as there's no other issues with it, that'll be good to go. So, yeah, that's not bad for a bunch of free bikes. No idea where I'm going to put them all yet. I think the ones I've done and the ones that have wheels in and will roll, I'll lock to the trailer out front. And I'll get the other two broken up for parts this evening and put on the trailer for scrap. Not that there's actually much on the black one to salvage. The back wheel and the 2 gear levers, I think that's just about it. There really is nothing else worth saving. The chain is completely rusted solid. So I think to get the wheel out, I'm going to have to take a hacksaw to the chain to cut it. There's no way I'm using a chain splitter on that, it's just too rusty. Although the orange Apollo, it does look bad, but I don't know, because it is doable. It needs a new crank. It's got one of those one-piece cranks that Apollo used to do. You know, like on a BMX. The cheaper BMX, not the stunt BMXs you get these days, but the older BMXs used to have a one-piece crank. It's just like one of them, but with three sprockets on the front. I've got a new one of those in the shed, so I could easily swap that. So I don't know, I'm going to use it as a donor bike just for the time being, because there's better bikes there to do. And obviously they've got to take priority, but I may keep it and, I don't know, strip it completely down and see how well the frame does clean up. And if it cleans up all right, then I may decide to put it back together at a later date. And if not, that'll just go out there on the scrap pile. It looks like the back wheel's been sitting underwater. Is that full of... I don't know. It's not rust, because it's an alloy wheel, but it's that full of shit and dirt. It does look like the sort of... residue, if you like, that you would get on something that was left in a pond or something. But it's only the back wheel, so it's like the back wheel has been left underwater. Yeah, the worst one is that black one, but it's got a nice set of gear shifters on that, which I'll pull off. I'll just cut the gear cables because they're not even worth saving. They're really, it's got to be one of the worst bikes I've had for a while, actually. That's worse than that Optima frame I've got up here. So I've got bikes up in this. I've got four frames up in the cupboard out here to work on. I've got that Trek that Biggles gave me, I've got that Optima frame, I've got my Carrera, I still need to get the hanger for, and my brother's Viking frame, which isn't, well, obviously isn't mine, it's my brother's. I wouldn't have said it's my brother's otherwise, would I? Duh. If you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm just standing at the window watching for Mum, as I'll see her come round the corner. Yeah. If I count the Oscar that I want to sell, the blue and yellow one, I've got about 100 quid's worth of bikes at least out there. If I sold them. If I sold them for the minimum of 20 quid, which I know the Emil is going to be worth at least 20, 25 quid. The Rally Girls one I'll clean up a lot better, and that'll probably be worth closer to 30. As for the Gents Apollo, it's a bigger frame than the Rally Stonefly, so my friend, as he's like 6 foot something tall, I can't remember exactly, he may find it more comfortable to ride than the Rally Stonefly. So I'm not in any hurry to sell it, you know, I've got the Oscar and two ladies' bikes, I can flog those for now. Yeah. I've got to find some wheels for the Apollo. Depends what time Mum says she's had enough cleaning in here, really. If I've got enough time, then I'll go down this evening and finish off the ladies' bikes and perhaps make a start on the Apollo. I better unplug this thing. It's had a long enough charge. Charging with G-Tech because the battery was dying. I don't think it's going to take us long in here at all. Might get Mum just to skim over my hair with the hair clippers while she's here. But I said she might as well park in the car park out the front here because there's no bugger on there. Three cars. And there's probably more chance of parking on here than there is on the main car park, which is at the other end of the block. Get four or five cars on there and it's full, and Usually they're not even residents to this block. I did have a moment where I was leaving polite little messages on the cars asking people not to park there unless they're visiting, but I can't be asked anymore, to be honest. I really can't. Although it's happened less now that the sign itself on the wall is visible, now that they've cut the tree down. Bloody hell, Mother, I don't take this long. Get from me. 20 minutes ago she said she was now leaving. 20 minutes to do 8 miles. Was she going at a snail pace? what have I got in there? Oh, yeah. I had to go and get some refuse sacks, didn't I? Because I forgot to get them. Yeah. Well, I've got to go down this evening at some point just to sort the bikes out, because they're all over the place out back at the minute. And if I leave it like it for too long, I will, quite rightly, get moaned at. Maybe not by the other residents, but by Victory Housing themselves if they see it or if someone complains. So I don't like leaving things out back for too long. I always clean up in the evenings if I've been out there during the day. So, if I do leave any bikes out there, they're only temporary, apart from perhaps the one or two that I'm using that are locked to the railings out back, which I don't even like to do either, because I have been moaned at from Victory Housing for doing that. Even though my neighbour below me does that, often. And I did actually point that out to Victory Housing when they did send an officer around. I said, well, I'm getting moaned at for it, but yet someone below me isn't. I just didn't think that was actually fair. But I haven't had any complaints for a while, so I always make sure that my handlebars are not poking through the railings so people don't walk into them. I'll turn the handlebars so they don't poke through. And they're always locked. And they're on gravel, so trust me, anyone tries walking on the gravel out there, because my bikes are locked directly below this window, I will hear them. And I will be out there quicker than they can blink. So those videotapes, I was just going to stack on this under this desk for the time being. Put the DVDs in there and get that up the corner. I'll actually have to put that up the corner first, won't I? Otherwise I won't be able to move it. Apart from that, I believe we are nearly done. Well, I've been on the camera 13 minutes. I don't know, Mum messaged me about 5-10 minutes before that, saying she was now leaving. Mind you, it is sort of a rush hour period. I don't know why they call it the rush hour, because it's like 2 hours or more, but there we go. Yeah, so there's probably heavy traffic she's got to contend with, and knowing her luck, she's probably got stuck behind a bloody tractor or something all the way here, doing 30 miles an hour. It is harvest season now. Oh well. So, I'm going to leave the suspension bike, the Muddy Fox, till last, I think. Just because it needs the most work doing to it. I need to trim my tash, because I'm eating it. Mind you, I'm going to shave, and I'm sort of debating whether to get rid of this, or whether to leave it. I don't know. I haven't decided yet. I may actually keep it, to be honest, and just trim around it. Fuck's sake. Yeah. Ooh, dust cap. Oh, neck and dust cap. I must have stolen that one. I did have some somewhere, now I need them. I can't remember where I put them. But there's one thing I'm getting short of down there. Got loads of wheels pumped up. But no dust caps. I don't know why, but I like to sell a bike with dust caps on. It's just one of them sort of OCD must. They must have dust caps on. I don't know, just the bike feels naked otherwise. Not naked, it just feels incomplete without dust caps on the valves. Wouldn't be surprised if I've got some in that yellow tub, to be honest. All lying on here. Did I pick it? I've got somewhere a little screwdriver, a bit like this, with a blue band. Ah, here it is. That actually belongs with my Bosch toolkit. I'm going to put up with that before I lose it. Here we go. I think this is the only bit that's missing. Yep. Pop you down there. It's my stepdad that got me this. It's quite a nifty little kit. Got all these various different Phillips and or crosshead screw bits and three little flathead bits. There's a socket adapter for the sockets. Get on there. Got some hexagon bits and a few star bits or Torx bits. And there's the screwdriver adapter that goes in the end of the little tool. 6, 7, 8, 10, and 13. I think this is actually meant to be for like washing machines and whatnot. I think that's why the sizes go like that. There's still a handy little sort of pocket toolkit to have. No idea how much it cost my stepdad, but he got two of them and he gave me one of them. So I've always kept that one complete. Barely been used. Oh yeah, and I forgot. Hang on. It's got a little slide up hook. So you can hang it up if you wanted to. Hang it up in the workshop. Unless Mum. I bet if I've. As I've walked away from the window, Mum may have gone round the other way and parked in the other car park. But, it is getting kind of worrying. Unless she's had to stop to put petrol in, I don't know. Oh. That's right, she was going to... Well, my sister said Mum may stop and pick her up on the way past. So that might be who she's waiting for. Something that... I may need to get a mouse mat, because this pattern on the desk is making my mouse cursor do all sorts of weird dances from time to time. And it's annoying. Well, that's a quick vlog. One thing I want to do tonight is I'll get some reviews done of some Lego sets, as many as I can really, so I'm going to actually turn this off, and save battery for that. Not that it matters, because I've actually got all three pairs charged, plus there's a point, I'm going to take these ones out. Because they're good. They're fully charged. These are the new ones I got. Now there is charge in them, but not full. When I put the pair in yesterday, it went straight down to 3 bars on the battery indicator. So what I'm actually going to do is pop these in this charger. I dropped one on the floor. Ugh, come here, you bastard. I'm just going to put them on charge for a couple of hours just to give them a little boost. Like that. Come on, biatch, where are you? Oh well, I'm going to turn the... What happened there? Well, I looked from the window to the camera screen, and it was all black for some reason, but it's still recording. Oh well. I've now been on camera 20 minutes, and still no sign of it. That's a bit annoying, because I could have gone downstairs and had that lady's bike all cleaned up, ready to go, but... Never mind. I'm going to turn the camera off, and I may go down and do that anyway while I'm waiting. So, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.